Welcome to ChemSpark guys, simple place for all level of chemistry. This is the part 2 session of part C questions which came in June 2018 NET exam. So earlier we solved 9 questions in part 1 session of part C. So now this is the part 2 session of part C. So rest I think 10 or 11 questions are there from organic which we will discuss in this video. So this is the first question This is the question we will discuss now. So this question is also from Clayton. Okay. So in this we can see this is a diol, 1-2 diol, which means it is a vicinal diol. And they can, whenever vicinal diol is there and toxic chloride is there, that means it's a kind of semi-pinnacle reaction. And this is reaction, this reagent is stabilized sulfur lead, which is we are using in Korre-Chekhovsky reaction. Okay. So we will discuss now this reaction. So as you can see, there's a diol and we have they have given one equivalent of tosyl chloride. And pyridine is the base they have given. So among these two OH group, primary alcohol is a more reactive for tosylation. Okay, so primary OH is converted into OTS because they have given one equivalent, and then they have given calcium carbonate. Calcium carbonate is just like a potassium carbonate only. It will remove this proton and it will give 1-2 shift and ring expansion will take place. Why we are not here used acid? Because non-acidic condition only tosylate can live. Otherwise, acidic condition, one more possibility is that it will give even elimination also. So in order to avoid that ambiguity, they have directly used calcium carbonate and we get ring expansion product as 1-2 shift. As you can see, this electron will come here and here 1-2 alkyl shift is there. So you will get 7-membered ring and this is also there in Clayton, in chapter, rearrangement chapter of Clayton. So then we have used, they have given this sulfur lead, stabilized sulfur lead. This reaction is Korre-Chekhovsky reaction. In this case particularly only ketone is there. So it will only form epoxide in this case. As you can see this epoxide. So our right option according to this question paper is our first option. As you can see, ring expansion product is 2 and here is you will get Korre-Chekhovsky reaction. If we use in this reaction directly HCl, na? If we directly acid in this reaction, so we are getting this product. This product we are getting, but in we are the condition which is giving the only we are only one product is possible, that is ring expansion product. Okay, so another question is based on we discuss about correct order of rate for the following reaction. They are this two is one kind of reaction. And those two is one kind of reaction. Okay, so they have asked just rate, they have asked which rate is greater, K1 or K2 or K3 and K4 like that. So we will discuss serially. So see these two example what I have written here, nucleophilic substitution via benzyne mechanism. Okay, and then what I have written, nucleophilic substitution, aromatic nucleophilic substitution. Okay, simple SNAR kind of reaction. So this now what we have to see. Which rate is greater for what? So always remember that whenever benzene mechanism is there, the order of halide reactivity order having a bromine is highly reactive for benzene, then iodine, then chlorine, then fluorine. Okay, actually there are so many discussion, but I am giving you a final crisp of discussion that because when you take bromine and iodine, na, that time redetermining step is H removal. This H removal is the redetermining step in benzene. When you have chlorine and fluorine, that time halide removal is a RDH step. Okay, but I am not going into that detail. I am directly giving you halogen reactivity. On that basis, I will discuss this question. And for if you want more detail on this, then there is only one book I found. That book name is Felix Carroll. Felix Carroll is the book's name. Felix Carroll. In that they have described it very nicely. Okay, so I just told you for benzene mechanism, bromine is highly reactive, potentially least reactive. And for SNR mechanism, we know whenever we have, this is the trend, fluorine is the most reactive, then chlorine, then bromine, then iodine in SNR reaction. Okay, SNR reaction, how we have to identify? One withdrawing group is there in this case. See, one withdrawing is there. So in this case, fluorine, one which is a more susceptible for attack of this nucleophile, that is fluorine, because there is a minor electron density is very least at this position as compared to this. So on the basis of that polarity, we are saying that fluorine is a good living group and iodine is a least living group, because removal of fluorine, attack of this reagent is a RDH step in this case. Okay, So it is very clear that this iodine and chlorine, iodine comes first, then chlorine. So K1 is greater than K2 for benzene mechanism, and for SNR mechanism, K4 is greater than K2 because of this trend. Okay, so by this logic, our answer is second option. Okay, if you have still, if you have some doubts, you can comment in inbox. I will discuss in detail in there. Okay, but for this question, we require this much concept only. Now, this question asked is from heterocyclic chemistry regarding pyridine reactivity. So, as you can see here, pyridine N oxide, they have given PNO, dimethyl pyridine N oxide, then acetic anhydride, then heated, we will get A product, which we again react with MCBB and acetic anhydride, under then anhydride, we will get B product. Okay, so we will discuss one by one this mechanism, one step by step this mechanism. So, as you know, PNO, O oxide is there. So, when we reacted with first acetic anhydride, then you know that acetic anhydride having an electrophilic acetyl group, CH3CO is an electrophile in this case. Okay, CH3CO plus I am writing here. So, O minus will get attacked to this carbonyl group, and then OSL will get formed. O acetylation will happen in this position. Then what is the byproduct of this? O acetate group, it's a very mild base, but this CH3 is a very acidic CH3, not this CH3 is acidic, always remember, by resonance we can prove also that. So this CH3 is acidic, so H2 plus is getting removed, and here CH2 minus will generate first, which will transfer at this position, and this nitrogen, the charge which having a nitrogen which having a charge, it is getting neutralized at this position, as you can see from here. Then what happened? Then free acetate ion is there in this liquid. Free acetate ion is there. It will go Michael addition. It will do Michael addition, and this bond will shift it at this position, and this acetyl will get removed. Actually, this step we can. There is a two mechanism for this. One which I have shown like Michael addition, and one more mechanism is there where you can prove it by. You can where you can prove it by 3-3 sigma tropic kind of reaction. Like if I give you only 1, 2, 3. And 1, 2, 3. So I will place here. This will go at this position, and this will transfer at this position. So this is basically from 3-3 also you can prove, or by simply Michael addition also you can prove this mechanism. Okay. So I have considered a Michael addition because in I think in Joulson will they have given this kind of mechanism only, but both are right. It's not right wrong. This is not nothing right, not right or wrong. So you will get this product. Okay. CH2AC. So once you get this product now, so you are only left with two options now. So you are left with only first and fourth option. These two are different, so we have to omit this. So now we have to look at second step mechanism. So again, what we have to do? MCBB is there. Again, N oxidation will take place. PNO will form. Now again, the same step. Acetic anhydride will come. Now same that one first time O acetylation will take place. Then OSL will get formed. Then acetate ion remove this H plus ion and will get this Michael type of adduct. Okay, this is this double bond we are getting here after this removal of H plus. This is shifted at this position, and then this charge neutralization will take place. I have not drawn here charge. This charge neutralization will take place. So here there is no charge in this, as you can see here. So now second molecule of acetate will come. Then it will go under Michael addition. Okay, again now this acetyl will get removed. Again we can prove this by 3-3 sigma tropic also. So we will get with GM diacetate. We will getting GM diacetate group, as you can see from here. When we add NOH into that, we will end up in getting formyl group. And what is the mechanism for that? As you can see, NOH is there, OH minus attack at this carbonyl carbon. Okay, this become O minus, H will become tetraethyl inverted. Then again, this O minus will transfer at this electron at this position. Then it will shift to this position, and OAC will get removed. Okay, and finally you are end up with CHO group. So directly you are getting from OAC to CHO group. Okay, via this 2AC group you are getting. When you add NOH into this, you will get this CHO group. Okay, so this is the basically lengthy mechanism, but if you follow step by step some rules, you will get easily, you are able to get simply, we are able to find this very simple mechanism. Okay, so now we will discuss ketene question. So What is the question they have asked for this reaction? For the following thermal 2 plus 2 cycle addition, thermal they have mentioned. The correct statement about transition state and preference for endoproduct formation. Now we are knowing that whenever 2 plus 2 photochemical 2 plus 2 is there, that time they will follow superficial addition, superficial addition. Okay, but whenever thermal 2 plus 2 is there, that means they are following superficial interfacial addition. Okay, from that we are only left with two options with us, second and third. Okay, and in ketene and aline this kind of two thermal 2 plus 2 take place in ketene and aline commonly. Okay, we will discuss before this question, we will discuss some basics about this reaction. Okay, so here I have taken dichloroketene, and here I have taken trans cyclooctene, and here I have taken cis cyclooctene. Okay, and we are getting at junction cis stereochemistry is maintained at junction, and here trans stereochemistry is maintained at junction. From this, what we can conclude, if we take cis alkene, we are getting cis fusion ring. If we take trans alkene, we are getting trans fusion ring. With then what we conclude that with respect to alkene, reaction must be superficial. Okay, that is very clear now. So as you can here I have drawn some basic TS to for understanding. So see, as you can see here, this is a ketene I have drawn here, and ketene with large group I placed here, and ketene with small group I placed here. Okay, and this is the alkene with small group I placed here, and large group I placed here to avoid steric hindrance in TS. And here you can see large group I placed here, and this TS is not formed. Okay, and this TS is formed. Once this TS is formed now, so what happened now? First, this double bond, and this ketene center sp carbon. This is sp carbon. This will get reacted first, and you will end up in getting this kind of bond. Then we have to rotate this. Curl this in order to get this planar system. So when you do this now, in this way in TS it is looking far away, but when you make it staggered, that time what happened? This become large group come one side. Okay, so here perpendicular approach. This is the perpendicular approach basically. Perpendicular approach due to sp carbon in ketene or in aline. In aline also this kind of possible. So this is basically superficial, interfacial kind of thing. Okay, so always remember. Now look at this one example. This example, this OAT is a large group. This is a small group, and this is a cis dimethyl I have taken. You will end up in getting. This is a cis only in this case, but OAT, MEME all are at more crowded is a major. Always remember, whenever you have a cycloaddition like ketene and aline, you will get more crowded product major. Why? Due to this transition state. Okay, so now again back to our question which asked in NET exam. So in they have taken ketene and they have given us olefin, and what they have asked, what is the transition state? Superficial or superficial interfacial? So now we can say that it is a superficial interfacial. So we only left with two options, either it is 2 or it is 3. Now what we have to discuss, in Diels-Alder reaction, whenever you have a cyanide group or CO2R group, that time what we are saying, it will form endoselective product whenever you have cyanide these groups. Okay, but in this case also, see now this is endo product I have drawn here, and this is exo product I have drawn here. Whenever R group is near to cavity, this is the cavity, when we are saying it is endo product. Whenever this R group is away from this cavity, I have not drawn it properly. Whenever this R group is away from this cavity, that time we are saying it is exo product. Okay, similarly in option in exam also they have given like that only, this endo product, R group near to this cavity, that is endo product. So always we have to keep in mind, whenever this R group is bulky, it will create repulsion, and with this cavity, more the bulkiness of this R group, more is the repulsion, and it will form exo product then. Okay, so see here methyl, ethyl, this R group I have taken here, isopropyl tetrabutyl. Tetrabutyl having endo product only 10. When this methyl with small group 76%. Okay, so you have to remember this. Okay, so for this way, our right answer is third one, ethyl isopropyl tetrabutyl. Okay, actually a very tricky, kind of tricky question, because normally people are not used to study ketene, and normally what we are knowing that always cycloaddition will follow superficial addition, but in case of ketene and aline it will follow superficial interfacial kind of cycloaddition. So now this reaction is also quite easy. Earlier it is also asking gate exam also, such kind of reactions. So basically first reaction is your Shapiro reaction followed by electrophilic addition, and second is your Johnson-Claisen rearrangement. Okay, so first we will discuss mechanism. So see here, whenever we have this hydrogen, tosyl hydrogen, this is tosyl hydrogen, that time we have to remember either it is a Bamford-Stevens or it is a Shapiro reaction. But in this case, whenever we have alkyl lithium, then it is a Shapiro reaction. Whenever it is an alkoxide base, then it is a Bamford reaction. So this reaction particularly is a Shapiro reaction, and they have given 2 equivalent of butyl lithium. So what I have done, I have first removed this acidic proton. This acidic proton I have removed from here, and this acidic proton I removed from here. So both anion will getting formed. Then what happened? Bodies bond pair will get, this electron will get shifted here. This will go here, and this tosyl will get removed. Tosyl is a good leaving group, as we know. Okay. So okay, here I make it in a two step. So whenever you have such kind of system, electron will shifted to this position. Here I have shown, it's wrong, you don't consider this position. So the red tosyl I have removed here. So see, now this is the alkene, and this alkene is a kinetic product, and we know that in Shapiro reaction we are getting kinetic product, in and in Bamford reaction we are getting this product. So in always remember that in Shapiro reaction we are getting least substituted alkene. That means this is a trisubstituted alkene. And now look at the other option. Look at now this option. This is a tetrasubstituted alkene. Whenever if we take base here like sodium ethoxide or sodium alkoxide or potassium tetrabutyloxide, then we are getting this thermodynamic alkene. That time it is one. But whenever we have alkyl lithium, we are getting kinetic product alkene. So our option is between this second one and this third one. We have only two options left with us. Okay. So this is a Shapiro reaction. Now this N2 will get removed again here. This nucleophile generated vinylic anion. Nucleophile generated here. This is basically vinyl anion, we can say. Vinyl anion. Now this is CHO. CHO is electrophile, CH2O. Formaldehyde is the electrophile. This negative charge attack at this CH2O and it become primary alcohol. Okay. Now for the second reaction, I have just started from starting onwards, because what they have given in starting, they have given you this triethoxy formate. Methyl formate, you can say triethoxymethyl formate they have given, and they have given propionic acid and temperature they have mentioned. So I have started with triethoxymethyl formate. When we add H plus, I have shown mechanism how it will form this compound. Okay, H plus will get protonated here, then this will show, then ethanol will get lost, will get here, then finally this product comes set here, and here our Shapiro product which we have made earlier, it can set here. Then OH will attack at this position, then this again charge neutralization, then removal of ethanol, then again this is the very crucial step. This is a very crucial step in Johnson-Claisen. Crucial step. So here again ethanol is acting as a base because it is a very acidic proton, that's why. Otherwise you normally cannot find this as a base. And then after the generation, we are already end up in getting 3-3 kind of system. As you can see, this allyl group 1-2-3 I have labeled here, and here 1-2-3 I have labeled here. So this 3-3 is getting formed, and finally you end up in getting this kind of product. So this is nothing but Johnson-Claisen rearrangement. Okay. Whenever you have such kind of system, triethoxy or formate, always remember that it will follow 3-3 sigmatropic reaction. Okay. Now another question is, this question also asked first time this time in NET exam. So for this I will show you options. Options is, look at down these options. They have given LD-TMS chloride, and this four kind of option, whether it's a 4-membered ring or 5-membered ring in first step, and second step is your Bailey-Leaver reaction. Okay, so we will start with this LD-TMS chloride. With X plus it is very common to open these rings, but they have given LD basic condition they have given. So first step we have to locate which is the acidic proton in this case. So via inductive effect I can say this is the acidic, most acidic proton among this all. So this X plus is getting removed, and here carbon anion will generate. So once this carbon anion will generate, it will transfer electron here, and this O minus will get open up. Once this O minus will become, then we have in system we have a TMS chloride. So it will attack to TMS. Okay, so OTMS will getting formed. Then if you do 1-2 shift like this, if we like this FI shift in 1-2 shift, if I done a transfer electron here and it shifted to here, then this is a less stable carbon anion. I will discuss in later. Then so we are getting a 4-membered ring here, as you can see, and this is a minor product in this case, and we know that 4-membered is a less stable. So another pathway is that another path pe hai. See, I have rotated it. I have drawn CH2 here and PH here in this case. So here what I have done, I have done 1,3 alkyl shift. Okay, 1,3 alkyl shift I have done. Again, I have transferred this electron at here. And now this electron will attack at this position. 1,3 alkyl shift I have done. So in here we are getting this stable carbon ion. Phenyl group is also there, withdrawing group also there. Then I see that phenyl group is not far away and withdrawing group is also far. So I am saying it is a less stable carbon ion. This is a stable carbon ion. So, and again, then finally we are getting here. Then charge neutralization I have done here. One chloride is there. Chloride will remove this TMS. This will become ketone. And when after quenching, after we have H plus in the system. So H plus will come at here and it will neutralize this negative charge. So this is a 5-membered ring, and we know that 5-membered ring is more stable than 4-membered ring. From that also we can see it is a major and this is a minor. And other way we can say this is intermediate which is forming here. This is less stable carbon ion. Here more stable carbon ion. So that also we can say this is a major amount. And finally what we have to do? MCBB we have to add. And we know that in Bayer-Willebrand reaction, aptitude of oxygen will go at that position where it found maximum stability. So stability means you can say migratory aptitude of this position is better than this position. This position is having good migratory aptitude, so oxygen will reside in between this. So this is very simple reaction, Bayer-Willebrand. But trickiest part is this 1,3 alkyl shift. I can also prove this by Michael addition also. But from this also I can prove, so I have not make it complicated. There are 2-3 ways to prove this. So I find it's very particular for this reaction mechanism. Okay. So again, our right option for this is then become. So see, from first option, if you know that this is 5-membered, then these two options left with us. Then for this Bayer-Willebrand is very simple. So it's a more substituted. It will form at this position. So for this is our option. Now this is a question asked from protection deprotection. Okay, so they have given this reagent. They have given D glucose and acetone H plus, palladium PDC, palladium dichromate, neutral reagent, very good reagent. And this is this will be able to form elide, phosphorus elide, stabilized phosphorus elide, as in case of Wittig reaction, Horner Wittig reaction. So we are able to. I have drawn just here D glucose in a Fischer form. Then I transfer. Then I converted into chair form, and here I have done alpha beta NMR both. So I have done here racemic I form I have done here, because this is known nothing like a major and minor, both are there. So here we cannot consider that beta is major and alpha is minor. I have drawn this racemic form. So when we use acetone and H plus condition, that time we know that acetone able to form 1,2 diol preferentially over 1,3 diol. Okay, so 1,2 diol getting protected here, and 1,2 diol also protected here in this fashion. Okay, but this protection is very easy, okay, because this both one time it becomes cis. So and this because this diol is 1,2 diol is a trans, so it's very difficult to protect this 1,2 diol as compared to this trans diol as compared to this cis 1,2 diol. And finally we have PDC with us. What will PDC do now? PDC will oxidize this primary alcohol to aldehyde. Again, PDC is a mild reagent, okay. They have not mentioned solvent about PDC, so we are considering it a mild reagent only. Because sometime what happened in PDC, if we have DMF, then it's so more reactive than compared to DCM. But here there is no question of that stability. So directly we have to consider PDC as a mild reagent, and primary alcohol to CH will get formed. Okay. Now finally, this reagent they have given this reagent and base they have given. So what will this base will do? This base will extract this proton and it will make it as a elide. And this again elide is a stabilized sulfur elide. And this reaction is Horner-Wittig reaction. And what we are getting we are getting E-alkene with this formyl group. This formyl group and this elide will get react, and we are getting E-alkene. As you can see from here, E-alkene, E-substitute, Z-transalkene or E-alkene we are getting. And this, I have transferred this into this form. These both are cis, as I mentioned here. This is both are, one is above and one is below, I mentioned here. This is E-alkene which I mentioned here. Okay, so right option for this question is, I guess, it's a fourth product. It's the right option. Okay. Now this is again, this is some challenging question. Here I am getting two products, both I am discussing with you. Exactly which product is major, that we will come to know after CHR and Serkey answer. But my guess is that this is the most probably a major product. Okay. Now in this case, what new they have done? They have taken urea and H2O2, and we know that urea and H2O2 is a, we don't know actually, it's a very new reagent for us also. The first time they have asked in NET and GATE exam. But urea and H2O2 is a new reagent for epoxidation. epoxidation. There are also two, three reagents are there, like dimethyl dioxirane. Such kind of urine acetate is not common that much. So, but this reagent is also used for epoxidation. So, student will get confused here only what this reagent will do. Then we have acid acid condition where this epoxide will get open up, and finally bromination will have. So, I am ending with these two products. So, I have drawn shown here the mechanism. So, see this cyclooctadiene I have drawn in different fashion. This fashion, top shape fashion. Then urea acetate, what will do? It will epoxidize from this bottom position. Then H3 will this epoxide will get open up in trans fashion. Then bromine I have used. Bromine also first grow at below position. Brominate. Then intramolecular nucleophilic attack. This is a transannular attack. Because why it is, what is transannular? Transannular means via covalent bond it is having a very large distance, but via space it is close by close to each other. Through space it is close to each other. So such attack we are known, naming it as a transannular attack. Okay, transannular means annulene kind of thing, bigger cyclic ring, and trans means is opposite, far away from each other, but through space is very close. So this OH will get upward, and this now see, look at this plane, this is above the plane. So this position both are above the plane, and this is the below the plane, this is also below the plane. Okay, so we end up in this product. So for this reaction, I'm that's why I'm saying this is the expected product most probably. Let's see what CSR answer will show. And another possibility is that don't consider this directly. If I use brominate, I will do bromination here. So I will getting end up in getting this bromine below the plane. Then if I use intramolecular attack suppose not take place, then bromide will attack at this position. And again now I have shown here bromide from this side, and again it will form transform bromide. Then intramolecular reaction will take place. This attack at this position, and this will attack at this position, and we end up in getting this product. So, OH is above the plane, which is above the plane. This OH is below the plane, so it is below the plane attack. Okay, so here we are getting this product. So, I am thinking this is a very large chances of getting this product, but this product possibly major product. Let's see what CSR and Sir Key will say. If there is a change, I will later on I will comment in. I will give more detail about this reaction. If there is any changes in there in Key. Now we are discussing about spectroscopy. So here in spectroscopy, what they have given, proton NMR data they have given. They also for 4 marks question. Then 7.9 delta, 7.9, 6.6. This is the aromatic region, okay. And this is the aliphatic region. But for this delta 4, they have given broad singlet, 2 hydrogen, D2 exchangeable, which means whether it is NH2. Okay. Let us see. I will show you proper example only. So, question is, here is the question. Here the question they have asked, D2 exchangeable, okay. And among these options, they have given D2 exchangeable, they have given directly NH2 or CuNH2, among these only competition is there, okay. So, this NH2 or CuNH2, we have this D2 exchangeable. We have competition between this only. And now look at the J value, this J8 hertz. That means this both protons are adjacent to each other and aromatic region. Now look at this position, J is equal to 6 hertz and J is equal to 6 hertz. This aliphatic region also, these protons are adjacent to each other, comprising 2 hydrogen and 3 hydrogen. So there are 4 options they have given here. So you can see that this only 2 type of aromatic protons are there, okay. So here we have 2 type of aromatic proton, here we have 2 type of aromatic proton, but here we have 4 type of aromatic proton. So this option is not there. Here also you can see 1, 2, 3. Here also we have almost three or four types of aromatic proton. So this is also not there. So we have competition between these two. Okay, whether it is a amine, aniline kind of NH2 or amide kind of NH2, and whether it is a ester or is a ether. Okay, so now we will discuss about this. Okay, now we will getting answer from chemical shift, because J value cannot give that much accuracy. J value only used to decide this para pattern. So chemical shift, as you can see, 7.9, as you can see here, 7.9 and 6.6. And 6.6 when it's possible, when you have aniline kind of system, like if you have this system aniline, like if you took aniline, and whenever we are taking this OME group, OCH3 group, both are donating group, both are donating electron to benzene ring, okay. But which is more better donor? Aniline is a better donor. So this carbon is more shielded compared to this carbon, okay. Whenever we have NH2, then this is more shielded than this carbon. So So from this one also we can get this answer. So as you can see, this is a better donor, and it will appear a better donor, more shielded. So this position 6.6, this position comes to 7.9 because it's a withdrawing group. But if it is a ether group, it will showing around, it will come around 7.1 or 7.2, it will show. So our from chemical shift only we can confirm that this is the aniline product. Another clue is that they have given delta value here. See, now delta broad singlet, delta value 4 they have given. So normally whenever we have aniline kind of system, like if we have already told this labile proton, actually it's not fixed, but probably it is coming around 4 to 4.5 whenever we have aromatic ring connected to NH2 labile proton. But whenever we have amide time kind of thing, like if we have this CO NH2, this NH2 is also labile, but it's comes around your 7 to 8 almost, it is coming this region. So what they have given here, 4.3 4 broad singlet, 2 hydrogen. That means again we have confirmed that it's NH2 only. So from chemical shift only we can recognize among these two. Okay, so everything is used, like J value, from J value we have neglected this C and D option, and from chemical shift we choose this option. Okay, mass is not that much crucial in this case for this both two example, because 165, 137 and 38, it will get, this also will get eliminated, this also will get eliminated, so it's not that much crucial. But chemical shift is very important part in this case. Another example, so UV spectroscopy example, as you can say theoretical example, what they have given, irradiation of either cis or trans steel beam at 330 nanometer results in the formation of a mixture of 93% cis and 7% trans, and they have asked this conclusion. So what I found basically, whether you take cis or trans steel beam, you irradiate it at 330 nanometer, you end up in getting 93% cis and 7% product, and they have asked us justification why it is happening. So basically this method is known as optical pumping method. So what solution I found it, I found true about this reaction. Second option I found very accurate. Again, why I found it more probable, because the molar extinction coefficient, molar absorptivity, basically molar absorptivity of trans steel beam is greater than the cis steel beam at this exciting wavelength. They have given this second option, and from data also I found that lambda max of trans steel beam is greater, as well as Emax is greater. Emax means molar absorptivity, so it will absorb more. So whether you take cis or trans, it will more able to, cis will forming more amount. Okay, exact reason, but that means more the absorptivity, more is the reactivity. So once cis is formed, then cis is not that much having a molar absorptivity, so it will not absorb light. But whenever it having a trans, once trans will form, then will undergo reaction is quickly. Once it form, it will go under reaction. But when it form the cis, it will not undergo reaction because of less Emax. So I am finding this cis is major in this case, not trans. Okay, due to this Emax value, I am concluding this. Final answer we come to know from CSR answer key only, but my probable explanation is this only. Because other option which is there, it is not that much relevant. What they have given, trans steel beam is more stable than cis steel beam, it is not, trans steel beam is more stable, but this is not, we can relate here. Then third option is transition state structure of cis and trans steel beams are different. From this also we cannot differentiate. Triplet excited state of this are also not that much relevant, because triplet we have to use sensitizer, but they have not mentioned about anything of sensitizer like benzophenone or we have to use. So most probably second option is the right option. And finally we have last question with us of NMR only. So this is also some kind of I think in GATE or TF or something they have asked this question earlier. So what they have given this, they have given cyclooctatetraene and they have X plus, and they have given this chemical shift value HA and HB. But which is the you will able to get, you will not able to find out this region properly, because this also, this proton region also based on like bond angle. I have read also research paper on this, but it's very very confusing. So main answer you are able to get from this HB and HA kind of thing. So as you can see from this, this HB is endo and this exo. So in the example you can see they have also confused more. They have given this PQRS, and in that only they have asked question. So as you can see, this HB proton is shielded. Why it is shielded? as we say, most shielded due to diamagnetic ring current of homotropic ion. So as you can see, the resonance. Okay, so here I will draw this kind of resonance. Okay, so this is a diamagnetic ring current from this side and paramagnetic ring current from this side. So HA is getting paramagnetic ring current and HB is getting diamagnetic ring current. So HB is getting more shielded as compared HB is getting shielded and HA is getting deshielded due to paramagnetic ring current. That's what I have read in research paper. But there is a more validation for this, like bond angle, and this, they are also considered as a cyclopropane. There's more discussion is there, but for the time being, you are able to answer this question from these two only. So as you can see here, I told you HB is a most deshielded, and it will come set most shielded. Sorry, not deshielded. HB is a most deshielded endo. HB is a most shielded. It will resonate at. It will appear at -0.3. So as you can see, HB means Q. Q means -0.3. Q means -0.3. Q is correspond to 1. So there are only two options left with us now. 1 and 3 option left with us. Okay, we can eliminate this option 3 and 4. 2 and 4. So among this HB, now HA, this is HA. Now HA, normally this is the aliphatic region. It will used to come at around what you say, around 2 or 2.5 used to appear, but due to this paramagnetic ring current, it will appear at 5.1. okay, it will appear at 5.1. so this P correspond to 2. P correspond to 2. So only we are right answer is first one. Okay, so right option is our first one. And this is our right option. As you can see, HB appears at -0.3, most shielded region. Most shielded region HB due to diamagnetic ring current. HA appears normally higher than the normal value. So due to paramagnetic ring current, as I shown, like in benzene we are discussing. This diamagnetic ring current. Whichever proton comes at here, it gets shielded, and whichever proton comes at here, it will get deshielded. Same logic I have used here. So HB and HA is confirmed. From this only we are getting our answer. We don't require this H1 to H7, H2 and H3, and it's very difficult to comment on this. So I avoid commenting on this because I have read about recent paper also. So it's very difficult to understand this because they also incorporated bond angle, angle strain, all those concepts here. So but we are able to answer this from these two proton value also. So they have not made that much. So they have not confused that much in this question. Finally, we have this EPR lines in CD3, and we know that deuterium having I value of 1. So 2Ni+1, I have to use this formula. 2 into 3 to 1, directly 7 line we are getting. Very simple question they have asked for 4 marks. Unexpected, this much simplicity is not expected. This much people will ask for 2 marks next year, but they have asked for 4 marks. It's a good news for you all. Okay, so this way we have completed all our organic chemistry question. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Thank you. If you have any suggestion, you can comment in inbox. Thank you.